salmon is more than just a fish. It's a species that connects marine environment with freshwater environment, with forests. When you have salmon in your river, you know your river is healthy.
Atlantic salmon sustained our Aboriginal people for thousands and thousands of years. They're always fighting for survival.
There's been a sharp decline in the 90s and since that time on salmon populations.
It makes me angry when I walk the river. What can I tell their children that it's soon going to be gone?
This population was listed as endangered under the Species at Risk Act in Canada, and that motivated action to do more than just monitoring, but to actually restore the population and try and avoid extinction.
When we were first putting the team together, it was very clear to all of us that Western science didn't have all the answers.
From day one, working with Fort Folly First Nation, we see these problems together.
We're a small community, but we're very mighty, and we care about the environment. By bringing the salmon back, we know it's going to sustain our people.
We didn't come to the table knowing what we needed to do. We came to the table knowing where we wanted to go.
I fished because it was a gift that was given to me by the Creator. It was a legacy that my father, my grandfather, and my great-grandfather left me. They were all fly fishermen and guides. That is why I feel so connected to the river.
We grew up fishing salmon when I was a young boy. We used to just fish in a canoe. There's no outboard motors. We just rowed around in little canoes with one line fishing the salmon. That's what did before Chiwat had really got ruined by logging, and it was really pristine at the time. My home has really changed since I was a child. It makes me angry when I walk the river. What can you tell your children that it's soon going to be gone?
We can't have ecological integrity unless all the parts are there, and the salmon is an integral part of this aquatic ecosystem.
The Inner Bay of Fundy salmon population began a drastic decline in the late 1990s, and that was due primarily to a significant decrease in fish leaving the river to successfully return from their marine migration.
No one knows for sure what the exact reason is, but certainly predation at sea, commercial fishing of salmon, and also climate change. As you can see, this year is a particularly dry year, a drought year, so salmon are having a hard time getting up the river to spawn.
This population was listed as endangered under the Species at Risk Act in Canada, and that motivated action to do more than just monitoring, but to actually restore the population and try and avoid extinction.
When we were first putting the team together to look at how we were going to restore salmon to the river, it was very clear to all of us that Western science didn't have all the answers.
My predecessor approached the local First Nation community at Fort Folly First Nation and spoke with then Chief Joe Knockwood and asked if Chief Joe would be interested in working with us together.
My uncle's passion for salmon, or blamu is what we call in Mi'kmaq, came when he was first born. That's his culture. On the Petitcodiac, my ancestors were guided in their winter encampments by the fish. For the summer, they would go to Beaumont. That's where our former reserve is, until they moved us here in Fort Folly. And when the salmon started to deteriorate in the Petitcodiac, he felt he had to do something about it.
A phrase called two-eyed seen, which coined by a Mi'kmaq elder in Cape Breton, Albert Marshall. What it says is, Western science doesn't have all the answers. Indigenous knowledge doesn't have all the answers. Western science really looks at generalities, looks at trends over time, and we put all this together to come up with theories. Indigenous knowledge, in my mind, it's place-based. So folks that have been on this land here for hundreds of years, if not thousands of years, two-eyed seeing, we can see together.
We're getting Fort Folly's perspective continuously.
We're a small community. We're very small, but we're very mighty, and we care about the environment. And so when we got together, it just felt natural. It just felt right.
In the early days, we really started with very little knowledge and capacity of restoring salmon populations. We didn't come to the table knowing what we needed to do. We came to the table knowing where we wanted to go. So we adopted techniques that were underway in other places, and that was a live gene banking process to ensure that we didn't lose critical diversity that already existed in the population from the remnant population.
Most of the conventional wisdom at the time was to reintroduce juvenile progeny, or smaller salmon, back into the rivers. They would grow them in hatcheries, supersaturate the river, and hope they would come back, but they weren't coming back.
Following 10 years of standard restoration methods, we were still failing to see any returning adult salmon, and we knew then that we would need to pursue more innovative partnerships and methods if we were to succeed.
In order to produce fish with as little captive exposure as possible, ideally those fish would be produced naturally in the river. To do that, we would need to release adult salmon. We developed an innovative partnership with the aquaculture industry, who has a deep capacity for growing and moving large numbers of adult-sized fish. Fort Folly and Parks Canada staff could collect the fish, the smolts, as they left the river to the ocean, to the aquaculture industry, who would grow them to the adult stage, would bring them back here, release them back into the river to spawn naturally and produce the next generation of fish in the wild.
The guardians and the team that we have actually put out the flight nets, capture the fish, tag the fish. That works hand in hand with what Parks is doing as well.
Techniques that we use are electrofishing to sample juveniles and monitor juvenile populations. We use snorkel surveys, a team of divers swimming down the river to count adults, and adults which return that are carrying a tag from our program are detected by antennas which are installed at the mouth, which operate 24 hours a day. Now, today, after nearly a decade of releasing adult fish, it is so predictable that the adults will return now, we are wondering how many, not if they will return, but how many will return. Cultural and ecological restoration are being carried by the presence of these adult salmon. Enter Betty Ward.
I joined this program about 3.5 years ago. I am from the Medabinagiak First Nation. The manager of the Rescon team, Corey Clark, comes walking in and he goes, "Is Betty Ward here?" And I said, "Right here." He said, "You know, you're famous." I said, "For salmon?" He asked me if I would come to do consulting as an elder.
She is now bringing Indigenous teaching and culture that has been missing, just like the aquatic productivity has been missing from this environment for the last 20 or 30 years.
When the salmon start to come back in, we do a ceremony on the beach and we welcome the salmon back.
We've never really had our culture here before. And just to see it come back, to see the youth hold that pride, I guess you can't explain the feeling, but you can see it on my face.
This was my first time releasing salmon in the Bay of Fundy. Even though I got wet, but it was the first time, but it was a nice feeling to let one go, knowing that I was part of this. They're going to come back maybe more into the future.
There are actually 7 Parks Canada administered sites across the country that all involved in various aspects of salmon restoration. Over 10 years in the 7 sites, we've restored about 65,000 hectares of habitat, which includes 228 kilometers of rivers and streams.
This is a dream that we can really make possible, and we're doing it every day.
In a world where environmental and ecological things generally are coming in negative stories. A group of people can get together and they can actually change the direction of some of those trends. I feel privileged to be part of an ecological story that is better now than it was 20 years ago.
It is a legacy that I'm going to leave behind for my sons and my grandchildren. And when I leave this world and go on to the spirit world, they will continue on and they will take care of Lamu.
Thanks so much for watching. For more videos like this, subscribe to the United Nations Environment Programme.